Okay, welcome back. Today, we are flying from Kushiro to Sapporo. In our first flight of the Japan part of the series, as I stated in previous episodes, we are going to be flying the length of Japan and down into Okinawa and Shimojishima. As slowly as possible to enjoy every single second of this. So, and today we're flying an aircraft that we haven't touched yet in this series, the Beechcraft King Air. I have flown it a couple times. It is actually pretty enjoyable to fly.
Zero traffic, Beechcraft, November 117, Delta Kilo, taking off runway.
And we won't be needing you, but I do want to adjust my I do want to adjust my seating position because that is not quite as tall as I actually am, and that's probably right. And then I want to zoom out as far as possible. Well, not that far, probably. I want to turn vertical speed on and heading select. And make sure... Ooh, what did I do? Dang, what are you doing? Oh, it's every time I hit that, huh? Just watching this right here to make sure that... I guess I could watch it over there, too. That is quite annoying. That'll be good for now. So, I'm intending on getting up to a reasonable altitude, turning on the autopilot, not worrying about the altitude mode or the GPS or anything like that, but just making sure that the aircraft is settled. So, flaps full. Actually, I don't think we need full flaps, but let's see. Brakes. And then check. Looks good. Okay. Good enough for me. Let's go. Full throttle for now, but we will need to pull back because this thing overspeeds like crazy. Gear up. Oh. Weirdly enough, it was okay with that. I don't know what's going on with this. Pull back on flaps a little bit. Oh, flaps are all the way out. That's cool. That's rad. And we have positive. Trim us out a little bit. Hey, welcome to the Beechcraft Beach King. Can't see a lot, can you? The visibility from the cockpit is pretty interesting. I mean, there's not a lot of ground either that you can see. That's okay. It's a pretty big aircraft. Well, actually, it's kind of a lot smaller than I thought it would be. It feels a lot smaller than I thought it would be. I guess the door is behind it. Yeah, excuse me. Was that masks? Yeah. Generator lights. I think we forgot to fuel up. But let's go ahead and throw on the autopilot here. We should have 0 feet per minute. Heading is on. $3,800 feet, not too shabby. And I'm gonna go ahead and refuel the plane. And crossfeed flow seems to be off though. Well, I guess if, we start to see an imbalance, we'll know to hit that. All right, well. Not much else to see, I guess. Autopilot's having a little bit of fun. I like these mountains. Let's get up to a little bit of altitude, huh? Up, 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 up. 500 foot per minute climb. I don't know what the max altitude of this aircraft is. Feels like something I should probably know. Do not smoke while oxygen is in use. Don't worry, I don't smoke anymore. What? Strange. Sorry, I'm just looking through all these because it's interesting. Helicopters don't really have all these, switches at the front. That is cool. You are an op. Luckily, we don't need. My gears are up. All these appear to be an op. You think, like, if a set of switches was important. As comms, crew, transmission, autocom, and up. You would think that, having all these switches on this aircraft, you know, that the aircraft the Beechcraft designed for specifically for this aircraft. You think that they will all be important? Doesn't appear so. As Microsoft has chosen to ignore some of them. I hope it's not snowy the whole way down to Okinawa. I kind of doubt it will be, though. I don't really know much about Hokkaido, to be honest. Okay, well, I'll pick you up in a little bit. I decided to level out at about 82-ish. It keeps changing, but I told it to level out at 82. That being said, I don't know what the terrain looks like completely. I don't know what the altitudes are. If I had a sectional or something like that, I'm sure I could do it, but also kind of just guessing on the barometric pressure at this point because I don't know. Kushiro didn't have a tower. As far as I could tell. Not that I checked, but what is this supposed to be here on the corner? Like a fold of leather? Is that not a little weird? Anyway, yeah, if we happen to, get ankle deep into the clouds, and, it looks like there's a mountain ahead of us, then we'll increase altitude. That's what this synthetic vision is for, so. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Almost halfway. I don't know if it's something that anybody else has noticed yet, but the I've been complaining about this the entire time that Microsoft Flight Sim has had VR, but there's been a, I don't know how long it's been there, but there's is now a scale for like a world scale, and I'm guessing it's like basically the distance between your eyes. I really don't know. But I changed it to 90%, and all of a sudden, this cockpit feels like the right size. Like, I don't think I was able to reach all the way across before. At least it certainly didn't feel like it. I'm actually now a tiny bit worried that this might be too small, but it looks smallish. Actually, I don't know how big this is. Like, are these supposed to be big? Am I supposed to be able to stand or something in here? Those cup holders are good indicators, I feel like. And those feel the right size. But how the hell am I supposed to know? The pedals feel like the right distance. Man, this is weird. I don't even know. I'll give it a shot. I'm gonna switch to other aircraft later. See if maybe, everything kind of feels better. I mean, even the prop looks like the right size, and I don't even know how big the prop is. I also turned down the quality of the trees and a bunch of other stuff because I feel like that was impeding on the record. The encoder lock or whatever was probably coming about as a result of that. So yeah, we'll give this a shot for now. I mean, this, my feet are probably just about as long as this, as the pedals are for me. So, maybe this is the right size. I don't know. I'll catch you when we land. Or, I guess when we begin descent, because it's coming up over there. Okay. Well, I can't find any documentation on how big that thing's supposed to be, the PFD, but it looks like it's supposed to be about as big as my hand times two, and that is exactly how big it feels here, so I'm guessing we finally have the right size. Now we're about to enter... that's probably it right there. So I'm going to disconnect, lower throttle, get you out of the way. What the heck is up with you? And then get us into a descent. Fuel is even on both sides. I don't know if that crossfeed is even necessary. I mean, we are leaning pretty heavily to one side. That's not like super important. Like, look, I let go, it rolls right a little bit. I just realized I've never landed this aircraft. It might be in for a treat of pain. Yep, that's definitely the airport up there. I'm guessing it wants us to come at it from like a left to right kind of way. So that's what we'll do. Don't know why you'd say that. Autopilot is not on. Landing here. Landing here. Landing here. Landing here. Landing here. Shush. Landing here. Landing here. Well, high up are we? Landing here. Landing here. Landing here. Landing here. Landing here. Landing here. God, you are annoying. Will you shut up? I'm actually kind of nervous. I don't think I've ever landed this aircraft. Ever. I have no experience with this. Probably should install it, though. I also don't know where the runway is, because everything's white. And we are still descending. Throw on a little bit of flap. Trim this out again. Looks like Sapporo down there. Throw down gear. She doesn't really fly much different, with, does she? We have greens. Looks like they're down. Still at 1,800 feet, so let's drop a little bit. That's definitely a runway. But I don't exactly know what I'm looking at, so. Man, why do all the buildings look gray? Is that just the snow? Oh, it could be. I bet you it's the right side. Nope, it's the left. It's a big gray item. No encoder lock. So now that I've said it, probably we'll find a little bit of encoder lock. We're still really high. Throw on a little bit of more flap. Yeah, it looks good. Drop some speed. out that much. Oh, my rudder pedal is stuck on my other, stuck on my other controls. There we go. Oh, wow. That was, interesting, to say the least. Well, let's get off the runway. This aircraft is also capable of reverse thrust, so theoretically I could use that to slow down, in the future, but I might, see about using another aircraft if we can. There are a ton of other aircraft that I haven't flown in this game. Faster aircraft or slower aircraft. You know, all the above. And we should probably give them a chance. That might be a helipad landing. Or a heli... just a helipad. Anyway. Thanks for coming along. I'll see you in the next one.